I'm here for your business with Chris Tavion Curtin, number one single ply 242 in the country. So Chris, you're preparing for the Ironman. What do you feel about your competition you face in Ohio?
Oh man, if Jules on the roster, I'm feeling it. I kind of feel like everybody else is in for second place and Jules has a good day. There's only one person I can really think that can touch Jules, and that's Greg Benoit. Greg Benoit's injury, he hasn't done multi-plot since then. I'm going to push the bar though. I'm planning to try 1,000 pounds and squat 700 pound bench and then try to take my deadlift over 800. I pulled 771 at the Olympics, so I'm pretty confident that I can get over 800 and 771 was pretty smooth.
So, Chris, you have a few challenges from Jason Coker and Zane Geddes. How do you feel going against two top lifters such as those two at Ironman?
Honestly, Zane getting the best squats at 935, which is about 5 inches high. I think his best total is like 2150. I don't even think he's really a great lifter. I think he's so average. I think he thinks he's a great lifter. Honestly, I'm opening up with a 920-pound squat. On my second attempt, I'm either going to go 965 to 1,000 and get it on that 920 goes. As for bench, me and Zane's taking the bench out due to the fact that he's suffered a torn calf. So we'll go head-to-head on deadlift. Yeah, I think, honestly, Zane Geddes can pull 800 pounds at any given moment, but his best at this point is 750. I plan to go over 800. On my second deadlift attempt, I'm going to make a 7.5 PR to beat him. As for Jason Coker never comes anywhere close to parallel on any of the squats that are over 900 pounds. The only time I've ever seen a break is in the APF when they made a break and gone, and his best squats are 8-something there. All of a sudden he goes to the west side, he's a 1,000-pound squatter. Jason Coker has a legitimate bench, he can bench with anybody in the country. His deadlift's around 550. I don't think Alto and Jason Coker will be a problem. I'm just going to let it fly and take some gambles in Ohio and see how it goes.
Recently, you were dropped from the USDA Texas State Chairman position. What are your plans as a meet director?
Our plans as a meet director is simple. I grew up in the USPF, looking up to guys like Ed Cohn, Steve Guyans, Gene Doe, guys who came through the USPF, all the legends in the USPF. I messaged Ed Cohn and just told him the situation of what happened with me losing my state chairman position. And all Ed said is don't worry about it. He gave me Lance Carabell's number, and I talked to Lance about everything. And Lance said, hey, we're more than happy to have you in the USPF. We understand what it takes to run meets and the things that you have to do. Just know that you have a team behind you, and we're going to support you through everything.
Now that you're no longer a part of the USPA, do you still plan to compete at the Olympia this year since you won that title in the past 2 years?
If Steve Dennison invites me to the Olympia, I'll compete at the Olympia. I want to compete at the Olympia. And the only reason that I want to compete at the Olympia is I want to show everybody that I'm the number one 242 in the nation. As I said last year, people said, the only reason you win the single ply events is that you never face anybody. So I asked Scott Smith, who was the number one at that time, to face me in Vegas. And I was actually losing about 61 pounds going into deadlift. And I told myself that, I wasn't going to be there with a loss. And I ended up beating Scott Smith by about 50 pounds, pulling a 771-pound deadlift and winning. Single ply is where I judge my heart by. Ever since I grew up watching Ed Cohn, who was my favorite lifter of all time, that's the standard that I live by, is single ply competition. I lived in multi-ply competitions just because those guys will never take off the gear and they run their mouths a lot. So, I like to go up and challenge myself and face them too. But at heart, I'll always be single-ply lifter. If I get put on the Olympia roster, I promise any 242 on the roster is going to lose that day.
All right, Chris, we appreciate your time for the interview, and good luck at Diamond.